You mute your voice. So today's topic is third lesson, transformation of trigonometric formulas. So what is this transformation mean? Means change. There are two categories, one and two. So here these are the number one, number two will come later. So number one means transformation of product of trigonometric ratios into sum or difference. The product of means multiplication is converted into sum or difference. That is the meaning. So let us start from here. We know sin a plus b equal to sin a cos b plus cos a sin b. In the same way, sin a minus b equal to sin a cos b minus cos a sin b. So these two formulas you know since class 9. Now let us move. If we'll simply add equation 1 and equation 2, so what shall we get? Left side sin a plus b plus sin a minus b equal to right side this cos a sin b and minus cos a sin b will cancel. This and this will be added. It will be 2 sin a cos b. Is it? So now write in the reverse order. 2 sin a cos b equal to sin a plus b plus sin a minus b. So this is first formula. Means left side you see it is product of sin a and cos b. Right side it is sum of sin a plus b and sin a minus b. So it is according to this topic, transformation from product to either sum or difference. This is sum, addition is there. Now second formula, subtracting from this 1 and 2, subtracting 2 from 1. So means this second line will be subtracted from first line. Sin a plus b minus sin a minus b. That will be, if you will subtract, this part will get cancelled. See the mouse movement. If on subtraction, sin a cos b minus sin a cos b will cancel. Cos a cos b minus minus will become plus 2 cos a cos b. 2 cos a sin b. So sin a plus b minus sin a minus b equal to 2 cos a sin b. Write in reverse manner. So 2 cos a sin b equal to sin a plus b minus sin a minus b. So this is product of sin a and cos b. This is difference of sin a plus b and sin a minus b. So product has been converted into difference. Now let us see third formula. To make formula, we have to rest upon this. Cos a plus b equal to cos a cos b minus sin a sin b. And cos a minus b equal to cos a cos b plus sin a sin b. Now if you will add first and second line, I have made it short. This side, if you will add two, this part will get cancelled. C plus minus, same thing. This is same. So 2 cos a cos b equal to cos a plus b plus cos a minus b. This is third formula. Here also product has been transformed into sum of two trigonometric ratios. Now last formula of this series, subtracting first from second, means first line is being subtracted from second line. So if here minus cos A cos B plus sin A sin B. If you will combine with this, this part will get cancelled. It will be added 2 sin A sin B equal to cos A minus B minus cos A plus B. Mind this instruction. Subtracting 1 from 2. Here it was subtracting 2 from 1. So nature is different. Subtracting 1 from 2, we will get 2 sin A sin B equal to cos A minus B minus cos A plus B. So if you have difficulty, you can later join virtual class and see this video again and again. Now let us go to second category. Transformation of sum or difference, either sum or difference of trigonometric ratios into product, reverse of previous one. This is new set of formula. So to prepare ourselves for new formulas, first we have to take some assumptions. Let A plus B equal to C and A minus B equal to D. Because A and B are numbers, sum of these two numbers is equal to C and difference of these two numbers is equal to D. Now if we will add these two, first line and second line, B and B will get cancelled, 2A equal to C plus D. Or you can write, whose mic is on? Switch off your mic. Now again 2A is C plus D, so A equal to C plus D by 2. Now again second operation, subtract this second line from first line. A will become minus A and B will become minus B will become plus B. A and minus A will get cancelled, B plus B will be 2B equal to C minus D, or B equal to C minus D by 2. Means wherever there is A plus B, we can replace it with C. A minus B can be replaced with D. A can be replaced with C plus D by 2. And B can be replaced with C minus D by 2. Now let us start with making formula. So in first set of formulas, what we have shown, sin A plus B plus sin A minus B equal to 2 sin A cos B. Now make these substitutions. A plus B can be replaced by C. A minus B can be replaced by D. A can be replaced by C plus D by 2 and B can be replaced by C minus D by 2. So what we have got? Sin C plus sin D equal to 2 sin C plus D by 2 into cos C minus D by 2. So this is new formula. If you mark here, left side it is sum of two trigonometric ratios, right side it is product of trigonometric ratios. So sum has been converted into product of two trigonometric ratios. Now second means we are taking tips from previous categories. Sin A plus B minus sin A minus B, it was equal to 2 cos A sin B. So A plus B replaced by C as before, A minus B replaced by D, A replaced by C plus D by 2 and B replaced by C minus D by 2. So what we have got, I have forgotten to highlight this, you can highlight sin C minus sin D equal to 2 cos C plus D by 2 into sin C minus D by 2. So what is the nature of this formula? The difference of two trigonometric ratios has been converted into product of trigonometric ratios. Now third, we already know cos A plus B plus cos A minus B equal to 2 cos A cos B. So A plus B is replaced by C, A minus B replaced by D, A replaced by C plus D by 2, and B replaced by C minus D by 2. So we have cos C plus cos D equal to 2 cos C plus D by 2 cos C minus D by 2. Here, the sum of two trigonometric ratios has been converted into product. Now, last, we know cos A minus B minus cos A plus B equal to 2 sin A sin B. Now, again, same kind of replacement. A minus B by D, A plus B by C, A by C plus D by 2, and B by C minus D by 2. So cos D minus cos C equal to 2 sin C plus D by 2 into sin C minus D by 2. But you know, this fourth formula, it is in different pattern. See here, first C and D, C and D, C and D, here D and C. So sometimes it breaks the flow how you memorize formulas. So to change this cos D minus cos C as cos C minus cos D, you have to change sign this side. Plus has to be made minus. So we will make compromise here that we will write cos C minus cos D equal to 2 sin C plus D by 2 into sin. Instead of C minus D by 2, we will adjust that minus sign here with sin D minus C by 2. So finally, these are the four. 1, 2, 3, 4 formulas. These formulas are used to convert sum or difference into product of trigonometric ratios. Okay? So those who have joined late, they can review in virtual class. Now, who is writing this? So if you will do any unwanted things, then I will block forever. Don't do like that. Now, let us see some solved examples. Like question is transformed into sum or difference. Question, this is product cos 24 degree multiplied by cos 12 degree. So you have to convert, transform this into sum, either sum or difference, whichever is possible. But you know, if you mark formulas, it was 2 sin A cos B, 2 cos A cos B, something like that. But here there is no 2. So first you insert 2, 1 by 2 into 2 sin 24 degree into cos 12 degree. So this bracket is 2 sin A cos B. A means 24. B means 12 degree. 2 sin A cos B, it is equal to, what is the formula? Recall, 2 sin A cos B equal to sin A plus B plus sin A minus B. So 24 plus 12 is 36. 24 minus 12 is 12. So this product has been transformed into sum of two trigonometric ratios. Now, just reverse. Transform into product. Here question is sum of two trigonometric. So they see there is plus sign. sum of two trigonometric ratios and instruction is to transform into product. So here apply one of the formula from second set. This C, this is D, cos C plus cos D equal to 2 cos C plus D by 2 into cos C minus D by 2. So if you work out 2 cos 10 theta by 2 into cos 2 theta by 2. So finally you have 2 cos 5 theta into cos theta. So sum has been transformed into product. Now next example, prove that sine 18 degree plus cos 18 degree equal to root 2 cos 27 degree. Now before we start, let us see this LHS. One is sine, one is cos. But if you recall formulas for this purpose, both are sine or both are cos. But here one is sine, one is cos. So you have to either take both into sine or both into cos. Then you proceed. Then you apply formula. So what we do? LHS, sine 18 degree plus cos 18 degree equal to sine 18 degree plus cos 18 degree can be written as sine 90 minus 18 degree. That is sine 72 degree. So now both are in sine. So sine C plus sine D formula can be applied here. The 2 sine C plus D by 2 cos C minus D by 2. So 18 plus 72 is 90. 90 by 2 is 45. And 18 minus 72 is minus 54. Minus 54 by 2 is minus 27. But this is with cos. Cos minus 27 degree. But you know cos minus theta is cos theta. It is peculiar with cos theta and sec theta. Cos minus theta means cos of negative angle is equal to cos of same angle with positive value. So it can be written as cos 27 degree and 2 sine 45 degree. You know value of sine 45 degree 1 by root 2. 2 by root 2 is root 2. So finally you have root 2 into cos 27 degree, which was to be proved. Now, third example. Question is prove that sine 4a plus sine 2a by cos 4a plus cos 2a equal to tan 3a. The numerator apply sine C plus sine D formula. A denominator cos C plus cos D. See how I have done. Numerator 2 sine C plus D by 2 into cos C minus D by 2. Denominator both are in cos, so 2 cos C plus D by 2 into cos C minus D by 2. You can revisit on formula page, then you will understand, because in the right place you have to apply right formula. Now 2 2 cancel, this part is common, so without simplifying we have cancelled. So what is left here? Cos 4a plus 2a by 2, 6a by 2. Sine 6a by 2 upon cos 6a by 2. 6a by 2 is 3a. Sine 3a by cos 3a, that is equal to tan 3a. Now, one very important question. This is asked in examinations also. Others can also be asked, but this is for 4 marks. Question is prove that cos 20 degree into cos 40 degree into cos 60 degree into cos 80 degree equal to 1 by 60. This is product of 4 trigonometric ratios. How to handle this type of problem? So let us start from LHS. Out of these 4, you know value of cos 60 degree. It is 1 by 2. So for that, we will write 1 by 2. And now, after taking out cos 60 degree as 1 by 2. Just a minute. Hello. Namaste, sir. Hazur. Kati baje auncha, sir? ए हुन्छ सर
अहिले छ मिटिङ छ सर, अहिले 11 बजे सचिवालयको अनलाइन बैठक छ, अब त्यसैमा छलफल हुँदैछ। भयो सर, उहाँ के भन्नुहुन्छ भने सरकारले के भनेको छ भने 5 गतेसम्म पर्खिनु, त्यसपछि केही मतलब राहतको कुरोहरू आउन सक्छ। अब हेरौँ सर के हुन्छ। के गर्ने सर, के न के त गरौँ कि छोडिदिउँ? म त अहिले क्लास गर्दै थिएँ सर। हजुर हुन्छ सर, ओके। So now, 1/2 for cos 60 degree, then cos 20, you 20, 40, 80 are left. So you can make group of any two. I have chosen 40 and 80 in one group and 20 separate. You can do in other way also. 1/2 cos 20 degree into cos 40 degree into cos 80 degree. Now, to apply formula, there should be 2. So 1/2 has been written as 1/4 and 2 inserted here. 1/4 cos 20 degree, 2 cos 40 into cos 80. 1/4 cos 20. Now 2 cos A cos B is cos A plus B plus cos A minus B. So here it is 40 plus 80 is 120, cos 120 plus cos minus 40 degree. Now you know value of cos 120 degree is -1/2, and cos minus theta is cos theta, so cos 40 degree. And now multiply this to this bracket. 1/4 into 1/2 is -1/2 cos 20 degree plus 1/4 this and this cos 40 into cos 20. Now next line. So again here you apply formula. So 1/4, let us write as 1/8 and insert 2. 2 cos 40, this is separate. 2 cos 40 into cos 20. Now, this left part is repeated till end. I am explaining only this. 1/8, 2 cos A cos B, cos A plus B plus cos A minus B. This is cos 60 degree and this is cos 20 degree. You know cos 60 degree is 1/2. 1/8 into 1/2. Plus 1/8 into cos 20 degree. So this minus cos, -1/8 cos 20 degree and +1/8 cos 20 degree cancelled. So it is 1/16. Okay. So this way you can prove this. So here now onwards, I am posting whole exercise, but you start from beginning and how much you can do, you give your reaction to me, I'll try to solve them. See, this is first page of all the questions. This is second page, top to bottom. So now I will stop this share. Now you can switch on your mic. Switch on your mic. So have you seen this chapter? What I have taught?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So go through repeatedly. You can go through them through virtual class. Then try to solve question and give your feedback to me. I am ending this class now. Okay?
Okay, sir.
Bye.